in 1 Peter 3:15. He said, but in your hearts revere Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have. But do this with gentleness and respect, keeping a clear conscience, so that those who speak maliciously against your good behavior in Christ may be ashamed of their slander. For it is better, if it is God's will, to suffer for doing good than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered once for our sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. He was put to death in the body, but made alive in the spirit. After being made alive, he went and made proclamation to the imprisoned spirit, to those who were disobedient long ago, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah, while the ark was being built. In it only a few people, 8 in all, were saved through water. And this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you also. Not the removal of death from the body, but the pledge of a clear conscience towards God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at God's right hand with angels, authorities, and powers in submission to him. And finally, be willing to look foolish for Jesus' sake. Be willing to look foolish for Jesus' sake. Your willingness to forgive, your willingness to give a little and to endure without seeking to settle the score may look foolish to the world. But remember the words of Paul, who wrote in 1 Corinthians 1:25, for the foolishness of God is wiser than man's wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than man's strength. When we cast our mind and memories back from where we started in this church for some 9 to 10 years going, why for some like me, 6 to 7 years now, and without any denial or disagreement, most of us, we are suffering from different problems, such as lack of decent accommodation, lack of gainful employment, lack of basic necessities, lack of means of transport to come to church, lack of a peaceful and fruitful family life, and spiritual growth of both the church and her members. Today we all know that we are not still in the same position. There's no one that God has not blessed. And if God has blessed us so graciously, how then can we all join hands together, setting aside all strifes and insensitivity? As Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 1:10, I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of you agree with one another in what you say, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be perfectly united in mind and thought. We have been praying for the growth of the church, and God will help us in the name of Jesus. We will not labor in vain. God will hear our prayer as we pray every day. I believe that God has already answered most of our prayers. Since most of us are now gainfully employed, we are living decent homes, riding good automobiles, and enjoying the blessings of additional children and our family. God is doing everything for us. I believe we can do it. But not in atmosphere of crisis. We can build our church, we can move to another place, but not in the atmosphere of crisis, anger, negative sensitivity, and strife. We have had enough problems in this church, which God has helped us to overcome over the years. And we should all be vigilant and be on guard not to allow Satan to come and plant any seed of confusion and hinder amidst us again. And we can do it by putting all spirit of confrontation, anger, confusion, bitterness, vision killers, enemies of progress, and negative sensitive people in our midst. Because Apostle Paul also warned us in Romans 16:17-18. Now I urge you, brethren, keep your eyes on those who cause dissension and hindrances contrary to the teaching which you have learned, and turn away from them, for such men are slaves, not of our Lord Jesus Christ, but of their own appetites. and by their smooth and flattering speech, they deceive the hearts of the unsuspecting. When we allow peace and love to reign in our church, in our home, we shall accomplish all that we have set our hearts to achieve. As our apostles taught us in 1 Corinthians 16, 13 to 14, be on the alert, stand firm in the faith, act like men, be strong, let all that you do be done in love. Let me close the Lord's message of this morning with grace and blessing of spiritual growth through Christ Jesus upon you all, as Apostle Paul pray for us. Can we bow down our head for prayer? When I think of this, I fall to my knees and pray to the Father, the creator of everything in heaven and on earth. I pray that from his glorious, unlimited resources, he will empower you with inner strength through his Spirit. Then Christ will make his home in your hearts as you trust in him. Your roots will grow down into God's love and keep you strong. And may you have the power to understand, as all God's people show, how wide, how long, how high, and how deep his love is. May you experience the love of Christ, though it is too great to understand fully. Then you will be made complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God. Now all glory to God, who is able, through his mighty power at work within us, to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask of or think. Glory to him in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations forever and ever. In Jesus' name, Father, we pray. Amen. May God bless you all.